So, Sam Seder, Ring of Fire Radio, thanks for being with me today. Where do you want to start with this week's news?
Let's start this program by noting the passing of someone who was an incredibly courageous, longtime fighter for many of the things that we talk about on this program. And I think, you know, a lot of people are familiar with that Jimmy Carter announced that he had cancer last week. And, you know, a lot of people are hoping that he will recover. He's obviously old, and there'll be time to talk about Jimmy Carter, and hopefully it won't be anytime soon. But this past week, really at the beginning of the week, Julian Bond passed away. He was obviously a civil rights leader, but so much more than that. He died at age 75. He was one of the original leaders of the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee, otherwise known as SNCC. SNCC, of course, has come up in the news quite a bit as of late, because Bernie Sanders was in the, as part of that organization, and has cited it as part of his past civil rights work. But he was much more than just an original leader of SNCC. He left that organization after the organization became a little more radicalized. He went on to involve in the NAACP, at what point he was chairman of the NAACP. He also ran and won for state legislature in Georgia back in 1965. And the Georgia State House, Farron, this is going to come as no surprise to some of our listeners, refused to sit him. They refused to allow him to take his seat. They ultimately were ordered to do so by the U.S. Supreme Court. This is a guy who served for 20 years in the Georgia General Assembly. He ran for Congress at one point against John Lewis. It apparently was a very nasty race, which he lost, but John Lewis and he have since made their peace. And as you know, Farron, Julian Bond became a founder with Morris Dees of the Southern Poverty Law Center, which is, of course, a legal advocacy group in Montgomery, Alabama. Bond was president from, I believe it was 1970 or 71 until 79. I know he served on the board. I know he was actually even in the studios down in Florida where you guys broadcast from.
He was. And, you know, it's remarkable for me to be sitting here where he sat so many times using the studio. And he would come in, and he was one of the nicest people I think we've ever had come through here. You know, very soft-spoken, but very powerful. When you listened to him speak, there wasn't this overlying angry tone, but it was a hopeful message. You know, he was very positive, very optimistic, regardless of, you know, what was happening, because he had seen the worst, and he had been through it, he had come through it, and he was actively working to make things better, and it was that optimism without the angry rhetoric that I think made him so powerful and so effective in what he did. And, you know, the Southern Poverty Law Center for a very long time has been very good friends with Ring of Fire. You know, people we talk to there constantly. And the work he did with that organization is just work that, you know, is so relevant today, so much more important today, I think, than in recent years. With everything we've seen with, you know, the increase in racial violence, racial tensions, police brutality, you know, that group, because of Julian Bond and because of Morris Dees, had been on the forefront of that for decades, and they still do. And Julian Bond, you know, it is a horrible loss, and I feel like now we really do need him and his voice and his message and his, you know, overall soft-spoken charisma, I guess is the best way to say it, more than ever.
And there was one story, too, that I wanted to just relate, that in 2006, when Coretta Scott King died, and obviously Julian Bond had marched and was close to Martin Luther King, Julian Bond refused to attend her funeral. And it was because of where her funeral took place. It was in a mega church in I believe it was in Atlanta, called the New Birth Missionary Baptist Church, and it was pastored by a man named Eddie Long. And according to Julian Bond, he refused to attend the funeral, I should say, because Eddie Long was a horrible homophobe. And he boycotted the funeral because of location. He said, "I knew her," speaking of Coretta Scott King, "and I knew she was a big defender of gay people's rights. I knew that Bishop Long was a raving homophobe, and I knew she would be twisting in her grave if she were buried there, and I'd be twisting in my grave if I went to the funeral there, and so I stayed away." It turns out that Bishop Long ended up charged with all sorts of horrible crimes involving 15-year-old boys. But Julian Bond had the courage at the time to stand up for rights, for civil rights of everyone. And I think that was indicative of the man he was. And so I think it's a terrible loss, but important to remember people for who they were. So much of what we have seen over the years, whether it was with Mandela or with Martin Luther King, is to many ways whitewash, if you will, their legacy as being less than as active and as determined and as radical in many respects. Julian Bond was a huge fighter against the Vietnam War, very anti-war. And much of this, I think, is swept away because the conventional wisdom in the mainstream media doesn't want to call it.